Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
And there is no need for an invocation, for you have all been in the spirit this whole weekend. And what is an invocation but invoking the awareness of spirit, not the presence of spirit, for as you have learned, spirit is ever present. It is you who are unaware most of your lives until the great awakening happens. We do make it sound as if it is one moment in time, and yet it is moment by moment, as you have learned, that the eyes open, the soul comes to the forefront, and remembrance occurs. This game of hide and seek, as you have heard it, that spirit is playing. And yes, at times, of course, it does not seem like a game. And it is not a game, but we use analogies all the time. For that is what you understand, stories. You are living a story. And all stories have interest, and they go up and down. Their ins and outs, the intricacies of the plot, and the plot thickens. And if it becomes a bit boring, why, you become a bit restless, and you seek adventure, and then when it comes and it has the down parts, then you say, what is this all about? And someone tells you that you had a choice to come here, and that you at a soul level planned this, and you said, no, I never would have done that. And I'm never coming back. It does sound a bit familiar, does it not? Oh, you are like children. We will play this game, but only on my terms. Yes. The name of the game is love. How much can you love? Yes, we come back to this topic over and over again. Well, what else matters to the human? Of course, success matters, amassing things and money, possessions, titles, all of those dressings matter for a while until they lose their importance. When you lose something that truly matters, and what could matter more than matters of the heart? When you lose one you love with all the heart, we put this in terms that you understand. You understand loss and gain. Your stockbroker understands loss and gain, and she gave that up to follow the heart. Can you feel the joy emanating from this one?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, of course. We are not telling you to give up your day job. We are not telling you to give up anything at all. If you were to give up anything at all, it would be the clinging to the story. Well, then there will be no more suffering, no more pain. Yes, there will be pain. It is part of this drama, this story. But pain does not have to come with suffering. Loss is a human term, one of your human words. And it is apt, it is appropriate. When one you love, with whom you have a relationship and you interact in your daily comings and goings, if only by your telephone or your internet, is no longer there, that is a loss. We understand this, but we come at this time to remind you they are still right here. And now this group, more than most, understands what we mean when we say they are here. Most humans will respond and say, how can they be here? for you are used to using the physical senses. You are used to touching them, hearing them, smelling their scent, and we understand this. And so for that reason, of course, it is a loss. But just remember the soul. The soul is ever present. It is not trapped within the body. It travels at night, you know. Where does it go? Nowhere. It is here. Yet it has adventures in consciousness. Just as you may do, some of you seeing dinosaurs when the gongs play. How lovely to get to visit and play with the dinosaurs. What would be the greatest adventure for you now? To travel and meet face to face with your beloved who has passed. What is holding you back? Belief. Skill at setting the story aside. For they are here, just as we are here. We have always been here with this one, the channel. We have always been part of the plan, waiting patiently while she saluted and shined her buckle. She was always a bit of a rebel in the uniform and did not understand it, for she was a rule follower as well. I saw many of you, we must stick to the rules. That is the rule of the game. Humans like rules. It brings order where there is chaos. Regimentation can be a good thing. It all depends upon the point of view. What is your goal? There is a need for order in this world. Why? For not all understand who they are. Not all are aware of the purpose at a human level. In each being you see, who does not play by the rules, is a soul. But the soul relinquishes awareness when it comes into a body. We often jokingly say, when the soul finds itself in the body of the newborn babe, it looks back and says, "My God, what have I done?" And then for a while, there is that walking of the balance between remembrance and forgetting, but soon the clouds do take over. And then it is time for the human life. And you will see that it does follow a bit of a pattern. You are here to be fully human. You are here to enjoy childhood, to suffer through adolescence, to try and find your personal identity. For Source came here to be unique. And that is why you see unique hairstyles and green hair color. That is uniqueness expressing itself. And those who enjoy regimentation cannot understand why would anyone want green hair? But why would God come into form to all dress alike, to all look alike? For a while it is fun, and there is great reason in certain groups dressing alike, looking alike, acting alike. For until all remember who they are, order is a good thing. Balance is the key. Love is always present. One can be a realist in this game and a dreamer. Find the balance or the vision of a brighter world. This room is quite bright, even when the lights are out. For all of you are following the calling of the heart, a metaphor for the soul knocking from within and saying, "I am in here, please." Please remove the blindfolds. And it is the human who says, I am not coming back. It is the soul who remains neutral and compassionate, as you have learned, who says, this too shall pass, for now it is quite interesting. All the many roles the soul can play. You have a choice, you know. You're not stuck. How is your role serving you now in fulfilling your purpose? Are you loving fully? It is quite all right to become angry, to be judgmental. All of those human things are part of this drama. Yet there comes a time when the soul says, enough of this childish game. I'm ready to shine. I'm ready to take a leadership role here. For nothing feels better than love. Connection is what it is all about, not separation. But that takes cooperation, and this does not happen without free will choices to cooperate. The spiritual path, there are many misconceptions about what it means to be spiritual. You can eat meat if you wish. That is a personal choice. Do so with love in your heart and gratitude for the souls of the animals who came here to provide their vessel as food. The souls of the animals do not suffer, but do not let any creature suffer. Learn to treat them with respect. You can be spiritual and imbibe in your fermented beverages, but do so with respect for the vessel. When it becomes excessive and causes you to act in less than loving ways to the body or to others, take a moment's pause and ask why. It feels good to the human. It is an escape. But even this realization is a beautiful spiritual lesson. And it does not mean that you can never imbibe or do other things to excess. All of these are learning opportunities. What goes up does come down. It is called a hangover. There are physical hangovers. There are emotional hangovers. All of these are simply indicators of being out of balance. They are not good, bad, right or wrong. Signposts on the path. Am I aligned with my true nature? You do not have to be aligned. It becomes a matter of, am I on purpose or not? And it is not even important to be on purpose all of the time. There are very few saints among you, save the husband. It is quite good to support one another on the journey. It is a loving thing to do. Love is the name of the game. You have willingly chosen to play it. Those who have passed continue playing this game with you. And again, we do not wish to negate or denigrate the suffering that takes place here by calling it a game. But when you know, truly know in your heart, that all that exists is this. Consciousness. then you do not take it quite so deeply that you suffer. You seek answers. You seek understanding. Yes, seek from others who share what they have learned, but seek first and foremost the personal experience of your true nature. And this does not come from reading a book or listening to recordings or listening to teachers. They most definitely do serve as signposts when they speak to the heart and you understand. Each person with whom you interact is a gift, as they allow your heart to open the portal to the soul, to widen, so that your love light can shine all the brighter they are. God's gift to you, but you are just as much a gift to them. Each light needs another to reflect upon. Come to know what true love is. Most humans have a bit of a skewed vision, understanding of love, for they were taught, I love pizza, and I love to ski, and my mother loved me. But yes, mother was a flawed human as well. All humans have human flaws. You understand our word. There's nothing wrong with this. We are using this term to indicate something that is out of alignment with true nature. The purest expression of love. That which we will call divine love. Not that it emanates from one being who knew love more than any other, but from pure connection, indivisible being, one, the wholeness which you have come here this weekend to understand, to experience, and to celebrate. Understand, hear us well. We celebrate you. You, blinded by the conditioning, the years of living in an eddy, a whirlpool of patterns of thoughts and sensations and feelings, have forgotten how magnificent you are. Yes, we know you soak up our words. You are so very loved, and it is truth. And yet, as you hear, you are so very loved. You hear it as if from a parent to a child. This you understand in human form. Some of you have never heard it from a parent, but have ached to hear it. And so these words are a salve to the wounded human, but not the wounded soul. There is no such thing. The soul is the light, and you are that. You are so very loved is merely a translation of an acknowledgement that the light that burns through you has no opposite. That the light that births you moment by moment is luminous beyond awareness in human form. You are cherished. You, the beautiful light known as a soul for a while, chose to have this experience in a human body. For this we honor you. For come what may, no matter what decisions you make, as long as they are not anathema to love, you will return, shining brighter. And that is the goal. You are the gift. Never doubt this. Never forget this. Go forth and no longer listen to those who tell you you are anything less than love, anything less than beautiful. You looked in the eyes of others last night and saw the beauty. That is your true nature. That is true beauty. You are so very beautiful. We shield our eyes as you realize this. Waste no more time shining dimly. Do not be afraid what others think. Why would you listen to one whose soul is occluded by false beliefs? Why would you give your attention there when the light within is calling your name? Love. Yes, of course, it takes courage to change your way of thinking. But oh, the rewards of living as the light. Oh, the rewards of standing for love, even when those around you remain in human mode. It is all right that they do so. What they do makes no difference to you. You are all source. Enjoy your journey. Simply shine. That is enough. We could go on all night and find different ways of telling you how beautiful you are. And we would happily do so, for you have had decades of telling yourselves quite the opposite. What a perverse world. And yet, feel this sensation you are experiencing now. Would you not love to gift it to others?
Yes.
You can, you know, simply by being yourself with a capital S. And that is why you forget. For there is such joy in remembering. Some will dig in and not want to change, and again, that is quite all right. It is a personal choice. Love never changes at your deepest essence. We are most happy to entertain questions now. If there is one of you with a question.
Do you have an opinion whether Jesus dictated the Course in Miracles?
He did indeed. One can read these words and feel the energy, and he will dictate directly to you if you wish as well, in more modern language. Whatever serves the moment, a great teacher is he. You can feel it in your heart. But we remind you again, what matter does it make? Who dictated what? Who is giving you what answer? Is it helpful? Is it healing? Does it come from the highest possible place? And who is Jesus? And who are you? And who are your guides? This one has done a good job of drilling this into your heads over and over. There will be a test. Is there another question?
Sanaya, this is a wonderful, unique group of people in this room. What did it take for those on the other side to get all of these beings here at this time and place?
We did not think in terms of all. Each had a guide that was working solely on their project, their individual human soul. Working in conjunction with the soul, what will it take to get them to the summit mission? Some quite a challenge, for others not so much a challenge. It was not a group meeting, as you would understand it, of spirit guides saying, you must amass exactly these. It is like a calling. There is an awareness of a certain energy potential that can be created from gatherings such as these. There is an affinity as this intention goes out, and the intention began here and spread and found a match energetically with those who are looking for the energy that was known that was going to be radiated from this synergetic combination, not just of the channel, but the team around the channel, the location, the partners serving with the channel, and the wisdom that we knew would be shared, for it was given to the channel from this team. You understand? It is all part of that web. Intention is the key. As the intention went out, it is like antennas go up. Ah, there's a workshop at Lee's Summit, a perfect match for this one here and that one here. Now we will begin to work on putting insights into their awareness and see if they respond. Quite interesting to see the machinations that go on without furrowing the brows. Simply a response to the energetic exchange. And is it not perfection?
Yes.
Is there another question?
Sanaya, do our guides find humor in a lot of our activities?
More than you can imagine. It's quite difficult to be a spirit guide, for we must be constantly watching, like herding cats, as you would say. We are showing you that, yes, there is always humor, for humor connects you all. This one was given the realization that what has been missing on the online gatherings of kindred spirits is the joy of laughter. Mm-hmm. It is a unique energetic signature, and you have enjoyed quite a bit of this here. Yes. And so while you may call it humor or laughter, we do not laugh at your foibles. It is an emotion, as you would understand it. Emotions have specific energetic signatures. For us, more so than laughter, we would call it bursts of joy, and sparkles that arise as we realize that humor is a beautiful way to bring those back to the heart. And there has been quite a bit of that here, which is why we also employ this tactic to remind you how joyous it is to connect. Is there another?
Sanaya, do spirit guides ever quit? Is it ever too difficult a job for a guide?
Quite a rare occasion that would be. And it is always an agreement with the soul with whom they are working. But quit is a human term. It is merely an exchange of guides, for there is greater opportunity either for the soul or for the guide. Do you understand?
Yes.
It is not a quitting, for that would indicate a failure of some sort. But very rare it is. Very rare.
Thank you.
And we will not go into the individual cases when this would happen, for they are quite unique in each situation. But please understand, it is always about the evolution, not just of the soul, but also of the guide. Perhaps a better opportunity comes along for that guide, and always the one that steps in to help is given a complete download of what has happened to that boy so that they can take over seamlessly and continue helping that soul.
Thank you.
Is there another?
Is dementia?
Go ahead.
Is dementia something joyous for the person that has it?
This is not a term we would use to describe it. And please understand the difference between the person and the soul. A person is the story, the characteristics, the traits, the patterns, the eddy. The person is what you know as a story, the biography of the person. It is an energetic signature. It belongs with the soul, but it is not a standalone entity. It is story. Does the body, mind, enjoy dementia? No, it is off balance. Does the soul enjoy? The soul is fine. It does not enjoy this. The soul finds great peace as it observes the body dealing with the poor wiring and the blockages. Do you understand? Watch the language carefully. Know that the soul of one with dementia is quite fine, still in complete communication with its guides, communicating with loved ones across the veil, as are all of you souls, when the human body person is not conscious, as in deep sleep. Is there another question?
And I hope can we stay focused when we are connected to our guides?
Set the intention to remain focused when connecting with higher consciousness. It is a training that takes place. At first, the thoughts within the conditioned mind, the conditioned energy field, will bubble up consistently. And so this is why we say training persistence helps with the focus, but do not let it become tedious. Please turn up the love if you would like us to answer a few more questions. The vessel is lagging a bit, but we do enjoy talking to you. Ah. Focus is quite important. To maintain awareness of one topic. And so train yourself to focus on awareness, to focus on one topic, to contemplate one topic, to maintain presence. These take time in human terms, these practices. Understand, none of them are necessary for awakening spiritually, for remembering who and what you are. But to maintain the connection, yes, focus is quite helpful. This one has gone through quite a bit of practice over the years. At first, it was quite difficult to maintain focus, but the military discipline did pay off. But this was augmented by the deep heart's desire both to serve and to learn from higher consciousness. We see in the auras of those present that you share this desire, you share this longing. The soul does not long. The soul loves connection. You at the human level interpret this magnetic pull as longing. Do you understand? Yes. Follow that pull. Practice presence. Work on focus. We do put it in quotations as you would understand that it is not work, it is a labor of love. For we do so enjoy communicating with you. It is a relief to us when you communicate with us back and forth. Have conversations with us, for we are real, we are here, we are beings We are sentient, and we hope we have demonstrated that we do enjoy a bit of humor. And so, interact with us. Do not put us on pedestals. We, your guides. You do not have to call us Sanaya. This is a name we have given to this one. If you want a name, we will give you one. Just talk to us. Ask us questions. We have been waiting for these intimate, interpersonal exchanges. Many of you do not believe it is possible. It is not reserved for just a few. If only more humans understood that you have helped us in this non-physical realm. It is our greatest joy to work with you. It is why we are here. Without you, we are without a job. More humor. Do you see what a difference it has made as soon as you turned up the heart? Yes. You play a very vital role in this world. You help each other. When those around you are flagging, lacking energy, suffering, you can make a difference. Send them love, whether or not they know it. You are their guides, yet you are not here to change them. Hear that again. Help them as you are guided. If they are open to it, that is a wonderful thing. If they are not, know that your love is felt at the soul level, deeply felt and appreciated. It is the human that needs the feedback, that needs to feel that appreciation in return, but the soul does not need it. Simply shine. We so love working with you. Your guides are excited that you are here. Your guides are looking forward to these personal conversations. When you ask a question as you are sipping your coffee and the divine, and you hear an answer, it did not come from the ether. It came from a loving being with what you would understand as a heart, even though it does not beat in a physical body. Answer them, thank them, interact with them. Soul embrace everyone. Even if they have no physical arms. It is true that you are the arms, the legs, the lips and tongue of spirit now. What a gift that is. At times it may seem a curse as the body begins to break down and no longer works the same, but the soul is always well, on duty to the last breath and beyond. Much to think about, is there not? But do not think too deeply, do not furrow those brows again. Simply feel it in the heart, let it flow around and percolate. Planting seeds always are we. And you will each blossom perfectly at the right time. There is no hurry, there is no comparing each other. We do not do that here in our realm. For we know what it is our greatest desire for you to know. You are so very loved. Yes. It can be no other way. We thank you so very much for following that call of the heart and being here. You do not have to change the world. A change is ever ongoing. Be that in balance with what never changes, love. We bid you good night.
Good night. Good night.